$10 million. Right now we are going to prepare a cash budget. Okay, so everyone draw that create a table in your notebook quickly. There should be a 5 columns. Now you have to do this example, students. So create a 5 column. First column detail, second column quarter 1, third column quarter 3, quarter 2, fourth column quarter 3, and last column is the quarter 4. Right, then you will put cash receivable. Then you allocate 1 or 2, 3, 4, 5 lines. Then you can put the cash collections, cash payments, right? And prepare the cash budget now. Cash budget, please create a column, 5 columns. Then you can put the details for the first column, second column quarter 1, quarter 2, quarter 3, quarter 4, right? Then you will put the collections and payments. Under the collections, you will put the beginning receivable and half of the sale, right? Then there's only one collections you can see here. Then everything is the payment. Account payable, 60% of the sales. Wages, taxes, and other expenses, 20% of the sales. That is the payments. Interest and dividend, that is payment. Major expansion plan for the quarter 2, that is also payment. So first you will get that cash receivable, then cash payments. Then you will get the net cash inflow. Because cash in receivable minus cash payables, then you will get the cash net flow. Then you will add the beginning of the cash balance in the first quarter, right? Then you will get the ending balance of the cash balance of the first quarter. Then first quarter cash balance will be the beginning cash balance for the second quarter, right? So do it now, please, quickly. The cash balance, cash budget. Done it. Students?
No, ma'am.
It is not understandable?
No, ma'am. The last part.
No.
Madam, beginning account receivable 120 means then quarter one balance will be the second quarter opening balance.
You know that 50% of the sales will be received when that beginning receivable will be that this half of the sales will be the receivable at the next quarter, no? Yes, you know, $200 the sales. Half of the sales you are receiving that or that quarter itself. Then rest of the 100 when you will receive it.
Next quarter
should be.
But then that beginning receivable 120 we have to include in the first quarter only.
First quarter only, yes. What about others? Students?
Yes, madam.
Have you done?
No, madam.
Why?
Actually, I couldn't understand, madam.
Why? We are talking about the cash budget, no? You did not come to the cash budget calculations.
No, madam.
Your man, sir, no?
Yes, madam.
Okay. We will do that example, let's you can see. What about Udara Bandara?
I'm doing, madam.
Okay, do it. Others will not open their mouth, but you can't do, no? Darshan. Who is Darshan? Dharan. Dharan, are you here?
Yes, madam.
Are you doing?
Yes, madam.
Okay. Okay, I'm going to read it again. The question expected sales by quarter, that is the information has been given in the million dollars. So they are preparing. So they did not say here because on this based on the information I am telling you, they are preparing the cash budgets on the quarter basis. Right? So there are four or five sentences you have. Based on this information, we are going to prepare a cash budget. Right, beginning account receivable for the quarter one, that is 120. Everyone, we can see. Beginning account receivable 120, then collections beginning receivables plus half of the sales, then account payable 60% of the sales, wages, taxes and other expenses 20% of the sales, then interest and dividends 20 million per quarter, and major expansion plan for the quarter two costing 100 million, and beginning cash balance 20 million with a minimum cash balance. Well, because the company should maintain the minimum cash balance 10. Right, beginning cash balance 20 million with the minimum cash balance also, that they have to maintain the minimum cash balance 10 million. Right, so now we got, this is the cash budget calculations. You can see the fund to is corporations, cash collections and cash disbursements, because I told you the cash collections, you have to put it here. Then cash disbursement, you have to put it here. Right. So I told you that five columns you have to prepare here. So this is the first column, students. So the quarter one, quarter two, quarter three, quarter four. Okay. So now we can see the beginning receivable as they have informed here. In the first quarter, beginning account receivable is 120. Right. That has been indicated here that the beginning receivable is 120, right? Then for the rest of the quarters, how we can found out that, how we can find out that, you know, that beginning receivable, because they have told us in this example, collections, how collections we can see, beginning receivable plus half of the sale. So the beginning receivable 120, then half of the sales 100. So rest of the 100 will be received at the second quarter, right? Because half of the sales will be received in a particular quarter and rest of them will be received at the, no, you know, that following quarter, right? So for the first quarter, the total sales $200, so that, you know, 50% will be received at that quarter. So the rest of the 100 will be receivable in the quarter two. So we can see that beginning receivable for the quarter two, that is 100, right? Then for that next quarter, we can see 300 is the quarter two sales. 150, they will receive on that particular quarter, then 150 will be receivable in the next quarter. So you can see the next quarter, 150, right? Then sales for the quarter three, you can see 250. So 50% will be on that quarter, then rest of the 50% will be receivable in the next quarter, right? So the beginning receivable we have identified now for the quarter 120, for the quarter 200, for the quarter 350 and quarter 325, right? Sales, we can put it here 200, 300, 250 and 400. Now we are going to calculate the cash collections. Cash collections, you can see, students, beginning receivable plus half of the sale. So the cash collection, look at here, 120 plus half of the sale, 100. So 120 plus 100, 220 is the cash collection for the quarter one. Then for the quarter two, beginning receivable 100, then plus half of the sale, 150. So 150 plus 100, 250 is the cash collection. Then quarter three, beginning receivable 150, then half of the sale 125, because 250 is the half 125. So 150 plus 125, that is 275 is the cash collection. Then quarter four, beginning cash receivable, then half of the sale, the half of the sale will be 200. 200 plus 120, 320 will be the cash collections. Okay, so 220, 250, 275, 325 are the cash collections for each quarters. Right? Did you get the same answer? Anyone? Students? Anyone, did you get the same answer for the cash collection? Yes? Tell me, please. Tell me.
Madam, can you please explain how did you calculate this cash collections?
That is the thing I am talking now. No.
Yes, madam, I didn't get.
Because you have to listen to me carefully. Because the beginning cash receivable, they have told us 120. Right? Look at here. Collections, beginning receivable plus half of the sale. Right? So cash collection, beginning receivable 120. Then half of the sales 200 million. Half of the sale 100. Then 100 plus 120, 220 is the cash collection. Got it?
Yes, madam. Now, okay.
Yeah. Then for the quarter two, the beginning receivable 100, half of the sale, 300 is the cash sales, half of the sales 150, then plus 100, 250 is the cash collection. Okay. Then 150 plus 125, 275. Then 120 plus 200, 325. That is the cash collection. That is the way you have to calculate the cash collection. Then you should know that as per the information given in this question, the sales, the half of the sales will be received in a particular quarter, then rest of them will be received in the next quarter, right? So in the sales, $200 million, you can see the half of the sales payment will be received on the quarter itself. So the rest of the 100 will be receivable at the next quarter. So the ending receivable 100, so this will be receivable in the second quarter. Then you can see the sales 300, half of the sales has been received by the second quarter, and rest of the 150 will be receivable in the third quarter. Then sales 250. Half of the sales they have received in the cash collection. Then rest of the 125 will be the beginning receivable for the fourth quarter. Right? Okay, students?
Okay.
Yeah, Udara?
Okay, madam.
Okay. Yes. Then cash disbursements. Because I can't call your names, because always when I called you, you never opened your mouth. So that who are the students who are active in the lectures, I could call them. Right? Because otherwise, how can I contact you now? If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Otherwise, we can't waste our time by calling your names, because you never open your mouth, no? Right. Cash disbursements, quarter one, quarter two, quarter three, quarter four, right? Payment of accounts, 60% of the sales will be the accounts payable. So the sales is here, you can see 200, 60% 120. Then you can see the sales 300 here, then 60% of the sales 180. Then 250 is the sales, 60% of the sales will be 150. 250 into 60, that is 150. Then sales, you can see 400, 60% of the sales will be the account payable. So 400 into 60, 240. So payable of accounts, 120, 180, 150, 240. How we have got it? This is the 60% of the sales, right? Then they have given us wages, taxes and other expenses they have given as per the information in the, you know, wages, taxes and other expenses, 20% of the sales, right? So the 20% of the sales, we can get it 200 into 20, 40, 300 into 20, 60, 250 into 20, 50, 400 into 20, 80. Right? Then capital expenditure, you can see the major expansion plan for the quarter two consisting 100 million. So that is for the quarter two capital expenditure for the quarter 200. In the other quarters, they don't have any. Right? Then we can see that interest and dividends 20 million per quarter. Right? Interest and dividends. So 20, 20, 20, 20, because that is per quarter, no? So we have to give that payment. Okay? So the total cash disbursement, now we can get it. 120 plus 40 plus 20. 180. Then 180 plus 60 plus 100 plus 20, that is 360. Then quarter 3, 150, 50, 20, that is 220. Then quarter 4, 240, 80 plus 20, so 340. So now we have got the total collections. That is only the 220, 250, 275, 325. Then total cash disbursements, 180, 360, 220, 340. Right? So now we have got to know that cash collection 220, 250, 275, 325. Then cash disbursements are there. So now we can put that net, now we can calculate the net cash flow for the quarters. You can see the total cash collections 220, 250, 275, 325. As per the calculations here, you can see now. Right. Then total cash disbursement 180, 360, 220, 340. You can see here the 180, 360, 220, 340. So now we can get the net cash flow, that is, you know, the receiver collections minus disbursement. 220 minus 180, that is 40. Then 250 minus 360. So this is the negative cash balance, cash net inflow, 110. Then 275 minus 220, that is 55. Then 325 minus 340, again there's a negative cash net inflow, 15. Okay?
Students. That quarter four total cash disbursement.
Yes. That is 340, no? You can see here. 60% of the sales, 240. Wages, taxes and other expenses, 80, because that is the 20% of the sales, 400 into 20, 80. Then the loan, long-term financing expenses, 20. So that is 340, no?
Okay.
So 325 is the total cash collections. The total cash disbursement, 340. So the net cash flow, 50. Everyone, tell me, is it okay with you?
Okay.
So far, if you have any questions, please ask me. Mansar.
Yes, madam.
Okay.
Okay, madam. I got the concept, madam.
Yeah.
But another one exercise.
May give the clear explanation. Yes. Because since the cash budget is very simple, students, because you can see, they will say which are the receivables and which are the payables, right? So based on that, this is the, you can see, this is the very, very, very small paragraph. You can see there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 lines only in the question, right? So the information, based on the information, we are going to prepare it, right? So the reason for putting this at the beginning, receivable, sales, collections, and ending receivable, for the understanding, because you will ask me how we have calculated the beginning receivable, madam. So I have to say, you know, that from the sales 200, 50% of the sales you will be receive the cash. For the rest of them, you will receive the next quarter. So then in the next quarter, the beginning receivable will be 100. So how I have got the ending receivable 150? Because 300 sales, 50% of the sales, they have received the cash. Then the rest of the 50%, they will receive the next quarter. So the ending receivable will be 350. Then 100, rest of the 150 plus 100, they have got the 250 as a cash collection. Right. You have to spend more time to do the exercises and everything. Then only you can understand. Right. You can get the questions from the previous students, they have some exercises and I think so now we have got the net cash flow to others, like that we have calculated, right? Then another thing we have to consider here, they have to maintain minimum $10 as a cash balance, right? The beginning cash balance in the quarter 120 with the minimum cash balance 10. So every quarter they have to maintain the minimum cash balance $10 million. That is the important thing we have to consider here. Every quarter they have to maintain the 20 million as a cash balance, sorry, 10 million. Okay. Yes. So now we can come to this rest of the you know, the calculations. That again I am putting here, that Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, right? Beginning cash balance for the first quarter only we know, but rest of the quarters we have to find out, right? So the beginning cash balance for this first quarter, as per the given information, you can see the beginning cash balance 20 billion, because obviously that should be identified. It is for the first quarter, right? So 20 million. So the 20 million beginning cash balance is here, right? Don't see the others other columns, that Q2, Q3, Q4, don't see now, right? Look at the column 1. So the beginning cash balance, as per the information given in the question, that is $20. Then net cash flow for the quarter 1, that is 40. Right? So for the particular quarter, they have earned the cash flow, that is 40, but beginning they have 20. Okay, students. So how much they have the money now? Tell me, please.
60 million.
60, yes. But there's a thing. They have to maintain the 10 million as a minimum close balance, right? So we have to keep that one, right? So $60 million they have earned in the quarter 1, but they have to maintain the cash balance. It has the 10 million. So how much is the cash surplus they have in the quarter 1?
50 million.
50 million, right. So actually, we have to separate it as the minimum cash balance, because for the because they have indicated, you know. So the beginning cash balance 20 and next cash balance 40. So the ending cash balance 60. this ending cash balance will be the beginning cash balance for the quarter 2. Okay, students?
Okay, madam.
Beginning 20, net cash flow 40, the ending cash balance 60. This ending cash balance will be the beginning cash balance for the quarter 2. But we have understood here that minimum 10 and cash surplus 50. This is for the just for the clear understanding, right? So now we have calculated the beginning cash balance 60 for the quarter 2. Okay, students, quarter 2. Yes, then we can see how much is the net cash flow for the quarter 2. We can see here the net cash flow for the quarter 2, $110 million. So now we are putting that one, $110 million. Okay. There's a problem in the organization because they earn anything in this quarter. They have the minus balance 120, right? So at the beginning they had $60, but they have to pay 110. That means the negative balance. So now we can calculate the ending cash balance 50. Have you understood? Plus 60 minus 110, that has given us the negative $50. Okay.
Okay, madam.
Okay. But for the understanding, we are differentiating this one because at the closing, because they have to maintain the minimum 10, right? So in this quarter, they don't have any money, but they have the negative cash balance 50. At the same time, they have to maintain the $10 million as a cash balance. So how much is the shortage for this company in the quarter 2? 60. Right, ending balance 50, already that is in the negative balance, but they have to maintain the 10 million. So they have the shortages, 60 million dollars for this company. Right, this is for the clear picture, we have put this one. Okay, for the clear picture. That surplus or deficit and minimum cash balance, it is not necessary, but we have put it here for the clear understanding of the students. Right. Now we have calculated the ending cash balance for the particular company's quarter 2. That is 50. Of course, we know this will be the closing. This closing balance will be the opening balance in the quarter 3. Okay, students?
Yes, madam.
Yes. That is the minus balance, right? Then we can see they have earned the net cash flow of $55. That is the positive one, right? So they have the beginning balance negative $50, $50 million, but they have earned $55 during the period. Now the ending balance, how much is that? $5. This ending balance will be the beginning balance for the quarter 2. That is, we know. But we can see here that company should maintain the minimum cash balance $10 million. So how much is the shortage for this company?
$5 million.
Yes. So this $5 million will be the beginning in the fourth quarter. Then you can see the students. The quarter 4, they have the net cash flow 15 minus balance, right? So we can put it here, the net cash flow for the quarter 4, that is 15. So how much is the ending balance? 10, of course, 10. Right. So this 10 will be beginning for the next year. But we can see, already company has the negative balance $10 million, and the same time company having a policy, has the policy they have to maintain the minimum cash balance, that is 10. So they have the deficit $20 million. Okay, so for the preparation, the students, for the purpose of the cash budget preparation, you can prepare the ending or cash balance. then you can it will be go for the beginning for the next year. Then the sending, it will be beginning for the next year. Descending, this will be beginning for the next year. So I have put it here, this one, to understand how much is the cash surplus or deficit for the each quarter of the company. I have put it here, right? Okay, okay students.
Okay.
So now I am asking you, have you done this question at the notebook now? Not yet, no?
Madam.
Yes, please.
Madam, I understand all the things, but I couldn't understand how to put in the 20 million in the quarter one beginning cash.
They have told us in the question. Beginning accounts receivable 120. That obviously we should understand that is in the quarter one, no? Because accounts is starting from the quarter one. Okay, student?
Okay.
Right. So I will send this PowerPoint slides to you, because question in the paragraph format. So I have extracted the questions in the bullet points. I think this question is available in the one of the book that is from this, you know, the budgeting. I think this is freely available in the book on the internet also, because this book is available, right? Okay, students, so now we have prepared the cash budget for a particular company with a small, this is small example, right? Now we are going to go for a next example, right? Students, everyone, have you done this in the notebook, in your notebook now?
Yes, ma'am.
That some of them you have did it, but because I am not sure about the others, because you know there are out of the 70 students, 57 only is here. Because, and also I would like to say, you students, because we have been requested by the, you know, your head and dean, we have to submit the participants list also. Do you know that is, we can get it from the Zoom in the reports. We can get the participants' details in each and every lecture time, right? Up to day before yesterday, I have prepared the participant list from the Zoom account. Then I have prepared that yesterday's assignment participants also, right? So I'm not sure about this, because I don't know what is the practice doing in the Vavuniya campus, Vavuniya University, but we will not allow the students without 80% of attendance for the lectures. Right? What about in your university?
Same practice, madam.
Same practice. So even they have attended in the quiz, but if they are not attending the lectures, so how they can sit for the final exam? Simply they will say it is the coverage problem. Students, okay, now we are going to do you want to take a 5 minutes break or to have a breakfast? Or we can continue. Students, tell me, please.
5 minutes break, ma'am.
Yes, take 5 minutes break and have your breakfast. Man sir, have your mommy prepared that breakfast?
Now she's preparing, madam.
Oh. So is it enough to you to 5 minutes to have it?
I think, madam, it's okay, madam. No problem, madam.
Yeah, take 5 minutes. Okay, take 6 minutes, right? Then we can start it. This is the next questions we are going to do. Come back, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So now we can see the question. The following table shows the sales for CPLC over the next 6 months. Right? For the next 6 months. So the C is a manufacturer of nutcrackers and so has a peak in its sales in December. Nutcrackers. In December, their sales will be peak. So, 1/3 of sales in any month are paid for the month of the delivery. 1/3 of sales. So, the sales payment will be received 1/3 in a particular month. The remainder paid 1 month later. So, the 2/3 will be received in the next month. Okay, listen to me carefully, my dear students. Following table shows the sales for the particular company. They have given us the 6 month information. They told us each and every month sales they have given us. Mm-hmm. 1/3 of sales will be received in a particular month, and 2/3 remainder they will get it in 1 month later. Right, so you can see here the sales, total sales for the August, September, October, November, December, January. Right, so now we have to prepare a budget for this monthly basis. You can see, students, total sales for this August 90, 90, 120, 150, 660. So now we can see the paid for in month of delivery. 1/3 will be paid. So we can see 1/3, 30. 1/3, it will be divided by 3, no? 30. 120 will be divided by 3, that is 40. 150 divided by 3, that is 50. 600 will be divided by 3, that is 200. Then 60 will be divided by 3, that is 20. Then rest of the money will be received in the 1 month later. So the next month they will receive. So the paid for 1 month later, how much? 90 minus 30, that is 60. 90 minus 30, that is 60. 120 minus 40, that is 80. 150 minus 50, that is 100. 600 minus 200, that is 400. Then 60 minus 20, that is 40. And because they have to give the previous month information, because in the sales of July, they have to give us, because in the 2/3 of sales in July will be received in August. Do you understand? Sales on credit outstanding at the end of the July are 60,000. So the credit outstanding is 60,000. Right? Next we can see the rest of the information. C maintains a constant level of output through the year and so builds up stocks in the autumn and early winter because there are some peak months are there for their production. So the during the October, an old machine tool will be replaced at a cost of 100,000 payable upon installation. They are purchasing a tool machine that costing 100,000 rupees with the installation. Also in the November edition of a glossy food drink magazine and range of nutcrackers will be promoted so that there's payment for that one 50,000. That means the advertisement cost, right? So you can see in the October they are purchasing one of the tool machine. Then the advertisement cost for the production, that is 50,000. In January, 150,000 tax will be payable in January. So the January they have to pay 150,000. So the particular month, how much is the payment? They are telling us. At the beginning of the August, cash balance will be positive 50,000. At the beginning of the August, cash balance will be the positive 50,000. expenses. Right. Payment for material. Anyway, I have to send this one to you. So the students, everyone in the meeting. Yes, management PPTs. Students?
Yes, ma'am.
They have sent this document via chat box, right? Right.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, now we can see the beginning of the August cash balance will be positive 50,000. Right. They have told us the cash balance also. Expenses detail. Payment for the material each and every month they have given us. Wages 20, 22, 25, 30, 22. Rent 10. Other expenses are this one. Calculate the cash budget. So you don't have the question, no? Right. This is the other one. So students,
yes,
this information, so I am so wait a minute, because you don't have the question, no? Can you see this now, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Everyone, so I am instructing you. First, you have to, you have to put the months detail and months. August, September, October, November, December. January. Right? You have to prepare a table, please. I will instruct you how you can prepare it. Detail. Then months, August, September, October, November, December, January. Prepare it, and then I am telling you how you can do it. This will be easier. The PP, this will be easiest. Right. Have you prepared the table, students? Then I am going to tell that. Have you prepared?
Details. Months, August to December.
6 month cash budget. So we can, because we have the information of August, September, October, November, December, January. The monthly basis budget, no. We don't need to worry about the years. Okay, students?
Okay.
Okay. So put that August, September, October, November, December, January. Okay. First, we are going to put that cash receivables, then cash disbursements. Okay? Students, first you put that cash receivables and allocate 2, 3, 4 lines, then you put that cash disbursements. Okay?
Okay.
Yes. Then we can see the cash receivable on August. In August. Sales on credit outstanding at the end of the July are 60,000. So how much is the outstanding? 60,000. Okay. This July outstanding will be receivable in August. Okay, students?
Okay.
You can see the remainder of the sales will pay it the next 1 month later. So the credit outstanding at the end of the July, 60,000, this will be receivable in the next month. So the beginning receivable for the cash balance, the accounts receivable in the August, that is 60,000. Okay, students? Okay, students?
Okay, ma'am.
Yes. Then, how much will be in the September? Account receivable. No. That is the cash collections 30. Receivable. Students. We are going to, you know, how can I? First, you will, you know, this is the format you will use it. In this, in, like this format, you will prepare. Beginning receivable, sales, cash collections, ending receivable. Like that you will put. Okay? So, you can put the beginning receivable 60 in the August. Right? In the second line, you can put the cash collections for the August 30, September 30. October 40, November 50, December 200, and January 20. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Right. So then based on this formula, format, you can put that cash collections for this August, September, October, November, December, then beginning receivable, put it. Right? Now you tell me how much will be the accounting receivable in September? How much?
30.
How much? July outstanding will be receivable 60 in the August, right? August outstanding will be receivable in the September. These are the receivable, no? Closing outstanding. Yes, wait for 1 month later. Students?
Then 2/3 of August will be received in September.
Yeah, because already we have calculated the 2/3, no?
Yes, ma'am.
This is 1/3. This is 1/3. So this is 2/3. We have divided that one. So we don't need to calculate it now. Straight away we can put it. Do you understand, students?
Yes, ma'am.
One, sir.
No, madam.
Students, you can see now we are going to prepare the cash balance for the August, September, October, November, December, January for the 6 month purpose, because we don't need to worry about the years because we are preparing the cash balance on the monthly basis. Okay. So now you have prepared a table with the months and detail, right? First, you will put the accounts receivable. Right, accounts receivable. That is, you know, every month they are making the sales. 1/3 of sales they are receiving the cash as immediately. Then 2/3 will be received in the next month. So the receivable 2/3 for the previous month. Because say, for example, in the August, account receivable will be previous month sales 2/3. Because they have told us this as the sales on total sales on credit outstanding. So this is the 2/3 amount, right? So this is the outstanding July amount will be receivable in August. Do you understand, Manstrad, this one?
That is okay, madam.
Yeah. Then you have to tell me how much will be receivable in the September, because August 16, now we have put it 60,000. Right? So how much will be account receivable in the September?
60,
that is 2/3 sales of the August. Do you understand, Mansar? July will be come to the August, August come to the September, September come to the October, October come to the November, November come to the December, right, Mansar?
Okay, madam.
This August outstanding balance will be receivable in the September, that is 60 again. Then September outstanding 60 will be receivable in the October again. Then October outstanding will be receivable in the November. Then November outstanding will be receivable in the December. The December outstanding will be receivable in the January. Right? Then this will be receivable in the February, because we did not prepare the February's one, so we have to leave this one. Do you understand, students?
Yes,
madam. Students?
Understood.
Yeah, this is same way we are going to use from the previous account example. Right? Then we can put the cash sales. How much is the cash sales? Cash collections, August 30, September 30, October 40, November 50, December 200, January 20. So that cash collections, cash sales collections, this one. So now we can get that total. Cash collections, how much is that? Tell me, how much is the total cash collections for the August? Danushika, how much?
90.
September?
90.
October?
100.
100. November?
30.
130. Yes. December?
300.
January?
420.
Yes. Everyone, have you got this cash collection, total cash collection, this says?
Madam, excuse me, madam.
Yes.
Madam, in our previous exercise, madam, the beginning receivable, the quarter one, 120, and sale, 200, madam. So then after we get cash collection, 220.
Yes.
Now, madam, so yes, here yes. The, we have to divide that 200 by 2. Then after we have to edit with
120.
Yes, madam. In the same scenario, we have to do in here, madam.
No, because in this question they have given us in this question they have told us 1/3 half of the sales will be receivable. So that we have divided 200 into 2, right? 100 then 120, 220 we have got it, Mansar. In this example, we will receive 1/3. 1/3 of the sales. 1/3 of the sales. Do you understand, Mansar?
Okay, madam. 1/3 meaning, madam?
It will be divided by 3 and 1/4 because you know the totals that you know you can see here. The total sales of this August is 90. It will be divided by 3. So how much is it will be divided by 3? How much?
30.
30. This is the 1/3. So how much is the 2/3? Tell me, please. 90 will be divided by 3 into, that is 60. Then 60 plus 30, that is 90. Because this in here we can put 1. Do you understand?
Okay, madam. Now okay, madam.
So then I am selling it as, telling it as 1/3 and 2/3. Okay, student? மன்சார் தமிழ் தானே
ஓ மேடம்
மன்சார் இப்ப அதுல முதல் சொல்லி இருக்கேன்னா காப் ஆஃப் த சேல் என்ன நாங்க ரெண்டாவதா கண்டால பிரிக்கிறோம் மன்சார் இதுல இவன் இதுல சொல்லப்பட்டிருக்கேன்னா 1/3 என்ன மூன்றுல ஒரு பகுதி தான் இதுல வரும் இல்லையா மூன்றா பிரிச்ச ஒரு பகுதி அந்த அந்த மாதமே காசா வர போதும் மிச்சம் ரெண்டா மிச்சம் மிச்சம் என்றாவில் தெரியும் தானே எங்களுக்கு மூன்றில் ரெண்டு பங்கு தானே
ஓ மேடம்
மூன்றில் ரெண்டு பங்கு வந்து அடுத்த மாதம் தான் எங்களுக்கு வேற போகுது இப்ப நான் உங்களுக்கு தமிழ்ல வழங்கப்படுத்துறேன்னு சொல்லி சொன்னா ஜூலை மாதம் அவையில் அவுட்ஸ்டாண்டிங் வந்து 60,000 இருக்குது இந்த அமௌண்ட் எல்லாம் தௌசண்ட்ஸ் எல்லாம் இருக்குது மூன்று சைவர் இங்க போடுபடையில பாத்தீங்க தானே தெரியும் தானே உங்களுக்கு இப்ப அப்பன் இதுல ஜூலை மாதம் அவையில் அவுட்ஸ்டாண்டிங் 60,000 இருக்குண்டா ஆகஸ்டுக்கு இது ரிசீவபிளா வரும் சரியோ என்னண்டா அவை சொல்லி நம்ம என்னென்றால் 1/3 ஆஃப் த சேல்ஸ் அந்த மாதத்திலேயே பே பண்றாங்களாம் மிச்சத்தை வந்து அதுக்கு அடுத்த மாதம் தான் பே பண்றாங்களாம் சேல்ஸ்ல சரியோ சரியா மன்சார்
ஓகே மேடம்
அப்ப இதுல ஜூலை மாதம் நடந்ததுல அவுட்ஸ்டாண்டிங் வந்து 60,000 தந்தா இந்த ஜூலை மாதம் அவுட்ஸ்டாண்டிங் வந்து ஆகஸ்ட்ல புறப்படும் தானே
ஓகே மேடம்
அப்ப இதுல அக்கவுண்ட்ஸ் ரிசீவபிள் அண்டு ஆகஸ்டுக்கு 60,000 வர போகுது சரியா அப்ப இதுல வந்து என்னன்னா நாங்கள் முதல் வந்து காஃபால பிரிச்சு நாங்கள் அவன் சொல்லி இருக்கிறான் இதுல ஃபிஃப்த் ஹாஃப் ஆஃப் த சேல்ஸ் ஆனா இந்த எக்ஸாம்பிள் அவன் சொல்லி இருக்கிறான் 1/3 ஆஃப் த சேல் விளங்குதா
ஓ மேடம் ஓ மேடம்
அதுதான் அதுல வித்தியாசம் ஓகேயா
ஓகே
So, Dhanushika, we have now collected the cash collections, right? Now, we are going to move on the cash payments, cash disbursements. Udara Bandara? Udara Bandara?
Yes, madam.
Have you calculated the cash collections correctly?
Yes, madam.
Okay. Then, what about the Taran?
Yes, madam.
Have you done it?
No, madam. Now I understood. You are, when we are you are explaining to Manasin.
Okay, okay. Yeah. If you want to explain it is in Tamil medium, so it is okay, no problem. But I can't speak in Singalam. So the Dhanushika, do you know Singalam how to talk it?
So, ma'am, I can manage, madam.
Okay. So because Mansa, do you know how to speak in Singalam?
No, madam.
No, so if you can talk it, because if I had told, if you, when I telling you the Tamil, you can talk to them in Sinhala, because oh no, because medium of instruction is English, no, so we can speak in English, because no worries, because if you couldn't understand, please tell us, students, I can explain you in our own language, right? Then now we are going to move on the disbursement sites, right? C maintains a constant level of output through year, and so it's okay, now we can put the cash disbursement straight away. A payment for the materials, August 50, September 50, October 55, November 55, December 55, and January 55, straight away we will put it. Then wages also straight away we will put it, 20, 20, 22, 25, 30, 22. And rent also we can put it 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, like that we can put it. Then other expenses also we can put it, right? Then we have to put it here, October. There's a cost, 100,000, right? Expenditure, October, for the machine, 100,000. So you have to put it, this one, in the cash disbursement. It is like, as you can see here, no? In this example, my dear students, you can see for the capital expenditure, we have spent 100,000. Like that, you can put this amount in the October, right? Do you understand, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Yes. Then November, they have spent the amount, that is 50,000, for the advertisement. So we have to put the advertisement 50,000 in the November. Right? Then January, 150,000 tax will be payable. So straight away we will put this one, because these are all same, we will put in the every month. Then October we will put 100,000. November we will put 50,000, and January we will put 150,000. Okay, students. Danushika. Okay. Now we are going to calculate the total cash payment. How much is that? For the August, 50, 20, 10, 10. So 90. In the September, 50, 20, 10, 10, 90. October 55 plus 22 plus 10 plus 11 plus 100,000. The 50, இது வந்து 55,000, நான் இந்த thousands லாம் details இருக்கு பிள்ளையல். So 55,000 plus 22,000 plus 10,000 plus 11,000 plus 100,000 in the October. Then November 55,000, 25,000, 10,000, 9,000, and 50,000 for the advertisement. Then January 55,000, 22,000, 10,000, 11,000, and the tax payment 150,000. So now we have calculated the total cash collections and cash total payments. Right. So come to this site. Now you can put the total cash collections for the every month and total cash payments for the every month. So students,
yes, ma'am.
Okay, how much is the total cash balance and how much is the total cash collection? You can put it, then you can get a net cash flow. Okay, then Shiga.
Okay, ma'am.
Then you will put the beginning of the cash balance, because as per the given information here, you can see they have told us that at the beginning of the August, cash balance will be 50,000, right? So as per this one, we will put the beginning of the cash balance, 50,000. Then we will put the net cash flow here. Then we can find out the ending cash balance. So this ending cash balance will be go to the beginning for the October, August, then September. Then September ending one will be go to that October. Then October ending will be go to November, like that you have to prepare. You don't need to worry about the minimum cash balance, because they did not tell anything about in this example, right? So calculate and show me your answer. Anyone? Udara Bandaravo, Danushika, show me your answers, please. Calculate it and tell me. Tell me. Mansar. Mansar?
Yes, madam.
Can you do this?
Yes, madam. I am doing, madam.
Doing. Okay, no problem. Darshan? Daran?
Yes, madam.
Are you doing?
Yes, madam.
Okay. Darshika? Darshika?
Yes, madam.
Are you doing?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Soumya? Have you done this? Who is this? 69. PM 69?
I'm doing, madam.
Are you doing?
I'm doing now.
Okay, good. Akila.
Yes, madam.
Are you doing?
Yes, madam, I'm doing.
Okay. So once you have finished, Darshika, Danushika, you have to share your answer with me. Or show me. Thank you.
Madam, I send it through the chat.
Okay, okay. So I couldn't see that one. Can you show this one here, Danishika? That answer to everyone.
Okay, ma'am. Yes, your screen disabled.
Oh, wait a minute. Yes. Now I have enabled to you. Yeah. So every students, so let's we can see here that account receivable. That is as per these calculations, this account receivable 60 is the July 1 and September, October, November, December, January. We can see because every previous month, 2/3 of sales will be the account receivable in this year. Then cash collections, they already we have calculated as per the given information they have given us. So we can put that one. Then total cash collection, we can get it 90, 90, 100, 130, 300 and 420. And as per the given information, cash disbursements they have given us, so straight away we can put those information. And there are three different information they have given us. One is the machine in the October, advertisement 50 in the November, tax in the January. So now we can get the total expenditures, that is, you know, that 90, 90, 190, 149, 105 and 248. Now we can calculate the cash balance, net cash flow, 90 minus 90, 0. Then again 90 and 90, 0. Then 100 minus 198, so minus 98 negative balance. Then 130 minus 149, so again make a negative balance, that is 90. Then 300 minus, 105, so luckily we have that positive balance 195. Then 420 minus 248, so 172 is the negative positive balance again. Then we have to see, my dear students, the opening balance in the August, they have given us 50. So the closing balance also 50. This closing balance will be the beginning balance in the September, right? Then again the closing balance in the September, that is 50. This 50 will be the opening balance in the October. Then we can get the net balance, that is the closing balance 48, because now minus 98 plus 50 minus 48. This minus 48 will be the beginning balance in the November. So again there is a negative balance, so the negative 19 and negative 48, the negative 67 in the closing balance in the November. This negative 67 will be the opening balance in the December. But December net cash flow was 195, then we can minus it 67. So luckily we have got the positive balance 128. This 128 will be the opening balance in the January. Then January net cash flow 172. So that closing balance is 300. Students?
Yes, Mansar?
Is it okay with you?
Yes, madam.
Are you prepared or preparing?
I am preparing, madam. First chart I did, madam.
Okay.
Second I am doing, madam.
Okay. So, what about the other students? Darren?
Yes, madam. I prepared until net cash flow.
Okay. So, in the meantime, we can talk to the Danushika when we can have the next lectures.
Tomorrow evening 4 o'clock.
4 to 5:30. Please give me two hours because the Nanda Govan also told me in the 17th they are closing the semester, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, please. So we can have it tomorrow 4 to 6. And also I would like to say, my dear students, there will be an unannounced assignments will be conducted to you. unannounced assignment will be conducted to you during the lecture hours, right? As I have instructed by the Thiru, he told me I need to give the two assignment better because the previously you did not have any assignment, so I need to give him two assignment. So one assignment will be conducted unannouncedly in that classroom, right? So I will not say when it is, but tomorrow 4 to 6 we have the lectures. Anyway, I will finish it a bit early because it is 6 o'clock now. So students,
yes ma'am,
because now you have the lectures at 9 o'clock, so now you are doing that. I hope everyone you have understood this one. So if you want to leave it, you can leave it, students, because you have the lectures at 9 o'clock now.
Yes, ma'am.
So now we have leaved it because this is the answer is correct. So everyone, you can please check your answers. If you have any doubts, you can ask me tomorrow. Okay, students?
Okay.
If you have any questions also, you can ask because I will be here. If you won't leave it, you can leave it because I think you did not have the breakfast. So if you want to go back for that, you can go.
Okay,
madam. Thank you very
tomorrow,
much.
Tomorrow 4 to 6, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you,
ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much.
Madam?
Yes.
In your next assignment, madam, will you give me by which chapter, madam, in this variance part?
Standard costing in variance.
Okay, madam.